Installing a building automation system, also known as a BAS, into a commercial building allows for automated control of HVAC systems, enabling greater comfort, reliability, and energy savings. But how is it that these automation systems control with such precision, leading to these benefits? One key component is the PID loop. PID loop is a control strategy used in many types of process control systems. PID stands for Proportional, Integral, Derivative, and in building automation systems, PID loops are used mainly for precise control of temperature, pressure, flow, or any other physical property within a system. A PID loop, also referred to as a control loop, consists of physical components such as sensors, dampers, valves, and a loop controller. In BACnet devices, the loop controller takes the form of a loop object within the BACnet controller. Let's look at a BACnet control loop that is typically found in a fan coil unit. In this loop, zone temperature is controlled with a valve that is open or closed to change water flow through a coil. Air flowing through the coil is warm or cooled to raise or lower the temperature in the room or zone. The zone set point is represented by the BACnet loop object's set point reference property and is fixed within the controller at 72 degrees. The output of the control loop controls the valve through the BACnet loop object's manipulated variable reference property. The zone temperature sensor is represented to the loop with the BACnet loop object's controlled variable reference property and provides feedback to the loop. When the zone temperature does not match the set point, the loop commands the valve to open or close until the zone temperature matches the set point. Now that we know what pieces are involved in our control loop, let's break down the four-step process running inside the control loop. The loop maintains control of either a flow, pressure, or temperature by the following. First, by sensing a condition such as a zone temperature, airflow, or duct pressure by using the appropriate sensor for the process. Next, we compare the measurement of the current condition to the desired set point. The set point may be a fixed value maintained in either a loop object or value object, or from a user input device, such as a thermostat. The control algorithm then responds within the loop object by reacting to any error that may exist by generating a corrective control signal. Finally, the loop adjusts by using the corrective control signal to command a device such as a valve, heater, or damper to produce a change in the current condition. The four steps of sensing, comparing, responding, and adjusting continuously operate within the PID loop. Loops are more efficient and, if used correctly, will automate control of heating and cooling zones with a high degree of accuracy. This is just the surface of how PID loops work. To see more in-depth information on PID loops, check out our application note in the link below or the other videos in this series and on our partner portal. For more information on building automation systems and how they can benefit you, check out the other videos on our channel, or to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.